for you.
Looking ahead.
I have assessed our encounter with the Netherbrain from every angle. I know why we failed. The problem was not the stones. The problem was you. You can make only one move at a time, but the Netherbrain calculates every possible move at once. It knows what you will do. It knows everything you could possibly do. You cannot outmaneuver it. To defeat it, you would have to think like an Illithid. Better yet, be one. Your mind is not capable of this. Mine is. You will give the stones to me. I will assimilate Orpheus, and then I will be able to leave this prison to face the brain.
This fella and his ultimatums. But he's forgetting one thing. We could become Illithid. I mean, I could. You could trust me to do what needs to be done.
You still don't trust me. After all we've been through, remember, I have been your salvation from the very beginning. Your knight in shining armor. I freed you from the Nautiloid, prevented you from crashing to your death. I have protected you ever since, at no small cost to myself. I came to you as a leader, but I did not shy away from showing you vulnerability. I needed you as much as you needed me. I was not above recognizing this. When you discovered my true identity, I did not flinch from the truth. I never lied to you, not once. I am just like you. We have the same enemy, the same story. I encouraged you to fulfill your potential, all while protecting you from harm. And when you saw what I truly am, you did not reject me. You enjoyed me. Now I ask you for the last time to trust me. Release the Netherstones to me.
Do not forget. There's a card yet to come into play. The orb. If you do not want to surrender the stones, you can still use it to ensure the brain's destruction. Along with my own, of course.
This is a risk we cannot take. Your hubris drives you even now. You failed before. I cannot trust that you will not fail again. You must trust me. Hand me the stones. I told you we have to trust one another. I told you the Githyanki would only want to kill you for what you are. Still, you choose to break our alliance. Even united, the Netherbrain was going to be an impossible enemy. But apart, we have no chance of survival. Very well. Since you will not work with me, you work against me. You leave me no option but to join the Netherbrain.
We can free Orpheus.
Doubt we'll get much in the way of gratitude. Only one way to find out.
A silent cry pierces your head. It's unlike any sensation you've ever felt.
You reek of Illithid. You fornicated with a mind flayer. And you slaughtered my honor guard. Nonetheless, it seems we must be allies. You may address me as your majesty. Make no mistake. Were it not for our common goal, I would strangle you where you stand. Your very existence tests my self-restraint. I will neither forgive nor forget your abuse of my powers. That is false. The opportunity to surrender yourself to my honor guard. They would have given you a noble end. Any worthy individual destined to become Geek would have done so. My guard would have freed me, and I would have stopped the Elder Brain before it evolved into a Nether Brain. All that suffering, avoidable, were it not for the choices you made. We will destroy the Netherbrain together, and put a stop to this nascent empire before it expands into the stars. The Geek was correct about one thing. The Netherbrain's power is beyond us. The hardest metal in the world would not cut through its mind, for it is made of thought itself. At this point, it will take an Illithid to unleash the full potential of the Netherstones.
Maybe you don't have to. It
should be me.
But it isn't a sacrifice. Not to me. I'm dying. This thing in my chest is burning me through.
If this is the end for me, let me be the motherfucker who saved the world.
Just as I was free, I will do it. I will become Illithid. I will sacrifice my soul for my people. I will end the grand design. It seems I misjudged you. You were testing my honor. And in so doing, you have convinced me of yours. The Netherbrain wants nothing more than to see all infected become Geek. My defenses keep the voice of the Absolute out. But just as I can raise them, so I can lower them. I will allow the voice of the Absolute in. Once it reaches you, it will order you to transform. It will only take a moment. And once you are a Mind Flayer, I will fold you under my protection once more. You will be the savior of empires. Not least, my own.
With the withdrawal of Orpheus's power, your mind is rushed with the full force of the Netherbrain. You feel compulsion unlike anything you've ever known. Excruciating and exhilarating in equal measure. You wish nothing in the world but to evolve. Then, complete silence, as you are once again closed off from the Netherbrain's mind.
My people will remember you. The rebel Illithid who stood beside their reborn prince and ended the grand design. Let us return now to the city and follow the path of the Netherbrain.
I looked unpleasant.
Come. It's time for us to meet our fates and end this Illithid. A most noble sacrifice. Gifts, blessings upon you, Rastil.
Has come! Shabar Orpheus! Shabar Orpheus! Shabar Orpheus!
Vos, my most loyal friend. How good to set eyes on you.
You honor me. Your radiance. A geish keeps you company. Unusual.
An Illithid in guise. An old ally in truth. She took this form so I might end the grand design.
Skvar! Can it be? Thanks to you, the skies above Tunarath shall tremble with sounds. Orpheus will take the truth to the people. We will slay the Lich Queen. Our chains will be cleaved. My sword is yours. We will exterminate the Brain and end its plague.
This champion holds the key to its defeat. Stand by for orders, Vos. Answer to her as you would answer to me.
As you wish, Prince Orpheus.
Forward! The Netherbrain falls this day. Let it be the first victim in the war for the skies!
lost much already. And we will lose more before the day is out. But even when the last soul falls, Baldur's Gate will stand. For Baldur's Gate is more than just a city. It is more than a place of opportunity for those of mercantile spirit. More than a place of refuge for those who are lost. More than a home for friends, loved ones, and adventuring souls. Baldur's Gate is a place where anyone can find what they need, if they're just willing to fight for it. Today, Baldur's Gate needs us. Today, we fight for...
You're late, friend. This is the one you spoke of.
The very same. The champion we've been waiting for. The one who will save Baldur's Gate from ruin.
The Fist eyes you with suspicion. He was not expecting the savior of Baldur's Gate to be a mind flayer.
Appearances may change, but they do not mask the one within. This one, I know. Observe with whom it traveleth. Friends. This mind flayer will fight with thee. It will save thy city and thy lives.
The Fist's suspicion softens to curiosity, his hostility melting at the recognition that there's more behind those eyes than malice.
My steel is yours,
mind flayer, and I'm not alone.
Never thought I'd be fighting alongside a mind flayer. But I'll fight with you. With magic.
I'm better at crafting steel than wielding it. Your friend here is armored and potion-fueled and ready for battle.
I have marshaled the best the Flaming Fist has to offer. We will fight to the last.
The Moon Maiden's silver light is a shield in dark times. Today, it is mine to wield, and I hold her sword.
Whatever strength I have to lend, I will lend it. I will make my city proud again.
Did you think I was gonna let you have all the fun? Mole looks out for her friends, mind flayers included. And she'll have your back, trust me.
I'm in the mood to crack some skulls after that fuckery in the Temple of Baal. The City Watch will be glad to oblige me.
Not sure what I have to offer a mind flayer, if I'm honest. But I hope my words of encouragement and reassurance will strengthen your, resolve.
The journey has been brutal, but I stand here a Hellrider once more. And I would die a proud man if I died this day.
I want my city back. And I've brought the toughest bastards from the guild to get the job done.
All the strength of the lands we healed flows through me, and from me to you, no matter what form you take.
Glad to have you with us, and not a moment too soon.
The air is thick with anticipation. All eyes are on you. They're expecting a speech, something to stir their hearts and put fire in their bellies for the fight ahead. What will a mind flayer say that could encourage them on the threshold of battle?
Prepare ourselves. We'll be ready when you call upon us. Baldurin's grace be with you.
Even I was surprised by how well the owlbear would take to the potions. Just look at it. Glorious little creature. Well, not so little anymore.
go! Let's go! Want to fight!
We have to keep running! Can't you see? It's over.
He's brightened up you, but the very fact you haven't killed him on sight gives him reason to pause. Can the rumors be true? Are you the Mind Flayer who could save the city? You feel his mind buckling, yielding. Against his better judgment, he trusts you.
Remarkable. Never in all my life did I think to fight alongside a Mind Flayer. Oh, we go back in there, we die, we flee, we last half a day at best. Shit! If this is it, then goddammit, let's make it count. City Watch, with me! We'll follow you to our last breaths.
Easy these days.
waste a step.
Thank you. yes. Say bye-bye.
On my way.
What's it gonna take?
I can't even catch my breath. I wonder if this is worth the cost. Oh!
Team in.
Close ranks. Light on my feet.
Need to learn the hard way.